We love hockey. The excitement, the energy, and the exhilaration. Like all collision sports, shoulders get slammed and knees get twisted. But what happens when the brain takes a hit?
Our brain is a soft, complex structure that is encased within a hard, protective shell. The brain is floating within a fluid bath that provides a shock absorption quality, such that if we turn our head one way or the other, our brain doesn't bump against the inside of our skull. However, if our head moves too fast and comes to too quick a stop, the shock absorbing qualities of the fluid that surround the brain are exceeded, and the brain will then hit up against a hard surface. This can cause neurologic injury, termed a concussion.
We might think it's like a bruise to the brain, but is it really something more?
The neurologic injury is invisible to most of our current technologies for imaging the brain, but there's injury that occurs at the microscopic level. You can see neuronal damage, you can see shearing of axons within the brain. Unfortunately, the ramifications of this injury may not become fully manifest until years down the road.
If we can't see a concussion, how can we watch out for it?
At all levels of hockey, it's important to have a high index of suspicion anytime there's contact to or around the head to a player, particularly to the boards or the ice. And I think it's better to err on the side of safety than to assume that someone is fine.
So we always hear on TV about concussion protocols, but what exactly are they? What's really going on in the locker room?
So the players who are suspected of having a concussion are taken off the ice and undergo a battery of a variety of tests. We go through their symptom inventory. We look for their balance. We assess visual changes. We assess any symptoms around the head or neck with motion that may indicate a neck injury in addition to concussion. In terms of the actual questions in the evaluation, we look for memory, we look for mental processing speed and recall, and those are compared to standardized answers that they've given previously in their baseline exam.
For those of us who haven't had a concussion, what's a player experiencing?
I think it's important to know that not all concussions result from big hits to the head or the body. Alternatively, not all hits to the body will result in a concussion. And so it's important that we monitor their symptoms, their mental processing speed on the ice, how they're seeing the game. They often say that the game is speeded up to them. They can't process what they needed to see on the ice when the puck is coming at them. They may say the lights are blinding to them or they cause a headache. And so there's various subtle symptoms or complaints that the players may have that may indicate a concussion when they have had no obvious head trauma or trauma to the body that may have induced an injury to the brain. It should also be known that some concussions don't manifest themselves to a day or two later.
NHL players take concussions seriously because they know their body has to last a lifetime. As fans and athletes, we should realize that too.
As a physician, I'm very happy that both players and the NHL has taken a strong stance on concussion management. I would say that high school athletes tend to try to hide their concussions way more than professional athletes. And I think the high school athletes are the ones that we have to be very, very careful with because of their developing brains.
Even if you're not a doctor, you can play an important role in concussion prevention.
It's also important for athletes at every level to be a good teammate. If they suspect that their teammate is not acting quite right, not running the correct plays, not processing things mentally like they should be, please notify your coach, notify their parent, notify the athletic trainer who's on the team with you to let them know that you're concerned about your friend and your teammate that they may have sustained a concussion.
When it comes to preventing concussions, we are all on the same team.
The brain is an amazing organ. It can take almost anything that we throw at it, but we do have to be careful. We recover usually very well from minor concussions, but we don't want to take too many chances, and we want to give ourselves plenty of time to rest after an injury to make sure that no permanent injury has been caused.
So use your head when it comes to concussions. And that's the science of St. Louis Blues hockey. Check out our other episodes and learn more about the science of St. Louis Blues hockey. Go to barnesjewish.org/scienceofblueshockey.